and welcome to my channel. Today's video is beginner yoga for seniors. For today's practice, we're gonna need a chair, something to lay on that's comfortable, and probably some head support for when we do lay down. So that could be a folded blanket or a cushion or pillow of some kind. So yoga for seniors is definitely a passion of mine. I just think that as we age, we want to keep working at maintaining our ability to move our bodies, our ability to have mobility and strength. And this is something that is definitely attainable for those of us who put the time and effort into it. So we're gonna get started. And just keep in mind, as we are moving, doesn't mean that everything's going to work for you at first. Don't be discouraged, just do your best. Don't harm yourself in the process and continue to practice and you'll see the results, you'll get better. So we've got our feet a little wider than our hips, bend your knees, and we're gonna go circles with our hips. So I'm going forward, side, back, side. And I'm drawing my belly in. And my knees are a little bit bent. And it doesn't matter what this looks like. It's all about just moving your hips in a way that you don't normally move them in life every day. And let's go the other way with the hips. Check in with your breathing. We want to breathe in and out through the nose. Maybe we're able to even slow down and deepen the breath. Okay, stopping with your hip circles. This next one is my personal favorite, one of my favorites. So we're going to start to swing the arms. Just start with little movements. So your torso is twisting, and then your arms just go with the momentum, I guess, or you can create momentum. And then the arms can start to go maybe a little higher and a little further wrapping around the body. And they do just kind of hit the body. And what this does is it decompresses the joints. So wrists, elbows, shoulders, and we're also twisting the spine. Draw your belly in, keep your knees bent. And again, it doesn't matter what it looks like, there's no right or wrong. And you're still breathing in and out through your nose. Just let those hands work, yeah. And then just let that momentum die down naturally. And then we're gonna come and use our chair. So we're gonna go hands wide on the chair, spread your fingers. Elbows are straight, walk your feet back, pull your belly in and lean your hips away from your hands and bring your chest towards the floor. You might need to walk your feet back a little bit more. So the goal is that our feet are under our hips. Our elbows are straight. Spread your fingers wide, like really spread them. Get that activation and that body-mind connection with the fingers and the hands. Lift your belly up away from the floor. Lift your front ribs away from the floor. And if that makes no sense to you, don't even worry about it. If it does, then great. And sink your chest. Line your head up with your spine. And this is a great forward fold for seniors because our head is above our heart. And what that means is, so if we have any eye conditions like glaucoma or heart conditions or blood pressure issues, low or high blood pressure, we want to make sure that our head does not go below our heart. And here is a situation where you can get a lovely back stretch and our head is in a position above our heart, so it's safe for that. If you do start to feel lightheaded or dizzy though, make sure that you come up sooner than I tell you. You come up right away if you feel lightheaded or dizzy. Spread your fingers. We'll go three more big breaths here. Spread your toes. Lean your hips and hands away from one another. Relax your neck. And then we're gonna bend our knees. We're gonna look to the chair, pull the belly in and walk towards your chair. Come on and stand up. Take your time. And then come on and sit down into your chair. Okay, so now we're gonna take our right hand, fingertips to shoulder. Grip your shoulder with your fingers. We're gonna go elbow circles forward. And I'm sitting on the middle of my sit bones. If that makes sense, great. If not, it's all good. We'll talk about it a little more later. Here again, it's normal to hear grinding and popping and lovely noises in your shoulder. It's all good. Let's go backwards circles. Reaching with your elbow, exploring your range of motion, gripping with your fingertips. And you can isolate just the arm and the shoulder, or you can move your ribs a little bit with the arm as well. Be intuitive with it. What feels good? Okay, left side. Left fingertips to left shoulder. Grip the shoulder. Forward circles. Backward circles, breathing in and out through your nose, going at your own pace. You can go much slower or quicker even if you want to. Relax your left arm. So we're gonna go back to the right side. Now we're gonna go straight arm and we're gonna go back up. Forward, down. If that's too intense on your shoulder, just go back to the fingertips on your shoulder and you can do a repeat. Otherwise, straight arm, extra noisy now. Extra cracky, grindy. And if you notice a repetitive crack, just reach your arm. Reach it away from you as you go through that space. We're going to go backward circles. And just allow the arm to rotate as it naturally does, taking breaks if you need to, especially if it's your first time trying yoga. Good for you. Okay, left side, same. So left arm straight, back up, forward, down. Back up, forward, down. And then other way. Keep reaching your arm away from your shoulder. Okay, relax your arm. Right arm in front. We're gonna take our right arm across our chest. Left hand can hold the right forearm and just draw the arm back. Try to keep your elbows straight. Press your right shoulder down. Lift your chest up. If it's comfortable, look to the right. And head back to center. Let your arms go. Left arm in front. Take your left arm across. Right hand can take the forearm. Press the shoulder down. Look to the left. Keep reaching with your left fingers. And head coming back to center. Let your arms go. Coming forward on your chair, and we're just going to start with our head. So chin tucking and head up a couple times. Don't necessarily look up, just lift the chin slightly. And then, so if you can just imagine in your mind what's going on with your upper neck right now, with your neck. You're kind of rounding it and then you're arching it a little bit, rounding and arching. Now come up and see if you can find that with your ribs. Round the ribs, arch the ribs. Round the ribs, arch the ribs. And this can be very unnatural. Hopefully it'll become more natural for you. I'm gripping my fingers on my knees because I find when I go to arch my ribs, if I pull back with my hands, I get a little more leverage. I'm rounding to broaden between the shoulder blades and then I'm arching. Rounding and arching. Shoulders forward when you round and shoulders back when you arch. Okay, now just the pelvis. So we're coming onto the front of the sit bones and then the back of the sit bones. Tilt the pelvis forward and back. Forward and back. So you may even be able to feel the bones that you're sitting on. So you want to go onto the back of them and the front of them. Okay, straight spine. Let's twist to the right. So right hand comes beside you or behind you, left hand outside your right knee. Lift into your chest and just think about breathing into the sides of your rib cage here. Breathe into the right and left sides. Grow tall on your exhale. Inhale. Expand through the sides of the ribs. Exhale, grow taller. Be very careful about trying to go deep. It's not really about going deep. It's actually more about convincing the body to let go of tension that it's unconsciously holding on to as we live our day-to-day lives. So forget about trying to go far or mimicking what I'm doing. More just do that little twist there and find that breath and focus on relaxing and basically defying gravity, growing taller and longer. And let's slowly unwind. Let's go the other way. So right hand to left or right leg, left hand beside you or behind you. And then we're breathing here. And what I really like about using the chair, especially when we're working with beginners or seniors, is that a lot of these shoulder stretches or spinal twists aren't accessible with a straight upright spine if we're sitting on the floor. So you're actually getting more bang for your buck by just lifting your hips up a little bit. So overall, it's going to feel better in the long run and you'll improve faster than if you were sitting on the floor. A few more breaths. Neck can be in a neutral position or looking over the back shoulder. Press into the right sit bone. And then slowly unwind. So starting with the hands on the thighs, let's toe heel the feet out a little bit. And we're gonna come forward over the thighs with a straight spine and then come back up. And I'm doing this with my hands on my thighs like I'm doing, sort of like I'm doing a like a tricep push-up if you're familiar. So I'm pushing into my hands to support my back as I come down and up. And I again, I'm just keeping a straight back and I'm bending at my hips. So I just wanna figure out what kind of range I have in this hip hinge. And so from here, we're gonna make our way onto the floor. So onto your yoga mat or a carpet, or you can even do it on the bed. So we're gonna come onto all fours and just making sure that in your transition, you're just as mindful, just as careful. So I've got my toes together and my knees apart, and I'm gonna just bring myself forward. So just like what we were practicing, hinging at the hips, coming forward, start by stacking your fists and just let your forehead rest on your fists and see how that goes. Something that's a nice opportunity here is the opportunity to straighten out your mid-back. So think about where it is that you tend to slouch and let that space sink forward towards the floor. I'm thinking belly lifting up away from the floor and chest sinking towards the floor. And so stacked fists might feel really good for you. You're working your hips heavy down towards your heels, or you might even be able to reach your arms overhead and stretch them away from you and let your forehead either rest on the floor or hover. If you do have a yoga block, you can use that for underneath your forehead as well. And so just sitting here and feeling into that stretch. Again, scanning the body for areas of tension and more focusing on softening, letting go, relaxing those spaces. This is an amazing pose to just stay in for a long time. So feel free to pause the video and stay here for 10 minutes if you want. Otherwise, we're going to come up, hands under your shoulders.
Bring yourself up. Let's come forward now into tabletop position. So bringing your knees under your hips so they're not wider than the hips. And then let's tuck the toes under and spread your fingers. Now, wrists might be a sensitive issue for you. So you might be on your palms or your fingertips, or your fists, or even your forearms is fine. We're not gonna be here for too long, but you, again, just don't wanna push through pain at all. If you are on your palms, really press into your fingertips, and we're gonna tuck our tailbone, round our ribs, and tuck our chin. And then look up, sink your chest, lift your sit bones. Same as what we did in the chair. Now it's all three parts combined. Tailbone tucks, ribs broaden, chin tucks. Tailbone lifts, head lifts, chest sinks. Tailbone and chin tucking, broaden the back ribs. Head and sit bones lifting, arch your mid back. So do that a couple more times. Exhale, curl.
Inhale, arch.
Exhale, curl. Inhale, arch. So cat-cow, this is a very typical yoga
exercise, yoga stretch. Keep going at your own pace.
It's just so effective for back tension and back pain.
This on its own incorporated into every day can make a significant difference in how your body feels and works.
Okay, and then just straight spine, draw your belly in, and let's walk the hands over to the right and then look over your right shoulder towards your right heel. And you're just gonna feel a stretch through the left side. Lean your left hip back. Walk your hands back into center. Draw your belly in. Walk your hands over to the left. Lean your right hip back and look over your left shoulder. and back into center. So now we're going to make our way onto our back. So we're going to go knees to one side, hips to the other side. Swing your legs around in front. This is where you might want to grab a cushion or a rolled up blanket for your head. And we're going to come onto our backs. Hands under your thighs, and we're going to roll down slowly one vertebra at a time, if possible. So adjust your head support so you're comfy. And we're going to find just a flat pelvis here. And we're going to draw our right knee in towards our chest. So hands behind the thigh or over the shin. Try to soften the shoulders down away from the ears. Maybe you're straightening out your left leg. Relax your right hip, send your breath into the spot where you feel resistance in your body. It's also beneficial to slightly resist the hands. So as your hands draw down on the leg, you can kind of just kick back into the hands. It's just engaging a little deeper into the hip, finding that strength within the mobility. Let's take the left foot down and the right foot down. So see if you can swap your interlace and draw your left knee in, hands to the shin or the thigh. Maybe you can straighten out your right leg. And taking your right foot down and your left foot down. So now we're going to come in to thread the needle. So right ankle to the left thigh and press your right knee away. And then see if you can take the flesh of the thigh and rotate it away from you. So the front of the thigh goes back and the bottom of the thigh comes towards you. So we get this nice external rotation in the hip. You want to flex your right foot. And so it's very common that in this position, we feel enough of a stretch, enough of a challenge. You'll notice that the right hip gets heavier into the floor here, so we want to push the left hip down into the floor as best we can, which is very subtle core strength, which is great to work on. If you're not feeling anything, you can lift off the left heel. And if you're still looking for something, you can maybe draw the legs in and grab onto the back of the thigh, the left thigh, and the right knee continues to press away. This is a great one to work on. I often kid about reading or watching TV in this position if it's an area of mobility that is challenging for you. Like, yeah, totally reading a book like this is going to help your back and your knees out quite a bit working on this hip mobility. And this is another one where you might like to pause the video so that you can hold it a little longer, but you can also come back to it at any time. So let's release the right leg. Just hinge the knee a few times, and then we're going to move on to the left side. Left ankle to right thigh and press your left knee away. Find that flesh of the left thigh rotated away from you. So back of the thigh towards your chest, top of the thigh towards the bottom edge of your mat or your foot. Press the right hip down, and you might stay here, or maybe drawing the legs in, grabbing on to the back of the right thigh.
we try to hold each side for the same period of time, staying present with your breath, moving your breath into the areas of the body that need that oxygen the most. And taking that right foot down, hinge your left knee a few times. And hugging both knees in, just do a few circles with the knees. So knees apart, away, together to you. Just move the hips freely a few times. And the other way with the circles. And taking the feet down, go wide on your mat with your feet and just let the knees go side to side. Okay, and then we're gonna lay down for something called Shavasana. So this is the pose where we want to relax completely. Some people find that their lower back is really sensitive when they straighten out their legs. So if you can straighten out your legs, go ahead and let the toes fall out. Otherwise, keeping your knees bent, you can let the knees lean together and the feet go wide, or you can even use your chair and prop your feet up on your chair, which is like really, really nice. And then we just want to reach our arms away from us, let the arms relax. Close your eyes and just feel into your body and notice how that effort has made an impact on how you're feeling right now. It's very common to notice that the body feels more relaxed, maybe energized, maybe lighter. It's also common to have a different kind of effect, like feeling agitated, or because sometimes when we have tension in our body, when we move through those blockages, we let go of emotional tension that we store in our body as well. So we kind of experience it on the way out. So just do your best not to attach to anything and just observe it as it moves in your body, as you feel it in your body. See if you can relax your face, your jaw, your eyes, your forehead. Can you soften your shoulders? Can you let the body be a little heavier into the floor? So I'm going to leave you to enjoy your Shavasana for as long as you like. Please stay a little while longer. I'd like to thank you so much for joining me today and for allowing me to share my practice with you. Namaste. And if you did enjoy that video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Have a great day.